You guys are supposed to be teaching me.
Like, I can't teach you.
You teach us.
Hello and welcome to Outside the Fots, where we explore what's happening online and why it matters. I'm Kim Horcher.
My name's AJ Patel. And Kim.
Yes.
Are you a tab hoarder or a tab minimalist?
I think you know the answer.
Minimalist.
No, oh, come on
damn
now.
It, damn it. Dang it, dang it, dang it. Darn, darn. So you're someone that has a lot of tabs open at like all times.
All the time.
Do you know where every single thing is whenever you need it?
Of course not.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes I do use a browser extension called One Tab, which will help with the memory because I have, again, tens of tabs open at a time. And it'll minimize them into one tab and kind of be a directory. I tend to do a lot of research, so I'm looking at different articles, I'm looking at different entries online, I'm just going through different avenues trying to find something out, and you know, I'll be like, I can't close that tab, I need it.
And then
here we are with a major tab situation.
Well, today, luckily, we have a special guest with us.
Please welcome Mike Conley. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Can you tell us a little bit about what you do at Mozilla?
Yeah, I'm a principal software developer working on Firefox desktop.
So you're on the desktop a lot, and I would imagine you're pretty productive. What are you typically doing in a workday?
Well, I have a lot of tabs, just like you. Hundreds of tabs sometimes. So yeah, it's flipping back and forth, looking at, reading about how some of the code inside of the browser, I'll be reading that inside some tabs, or reading bug reports in other tabs and flipping back and forth reading code and then switching over to my editor to change some of the code. And so, yeah, I'm doing a lot of tab management myself.
What are some things you do to manage them?
First of all, I make use of the awesome bar. So the URL bar, we call it the awesome bar, like amongst colleagues and Mozillians, we call it the awesome bar. But it allows you to search not just on the internet, like to do a Google search or something, but you can search just the open tabs that you have. And I use that all the time. Mm-hmm. So if I type in the @ symbol and then the word tabs and then hit the tab key, then I'll only be searching for the tabs that are open. And that's very helpful if I'm looking for a particular tab. Like, oh, I was just looking at this article about, I don't know, hamsters or something. @tabs, hamsters. And then it will find it. It will just show it in the list and it'll switch to it as soon as I have a result. The other one is tab groups are very helpful. This is something new. So I'm not using stock Firefox right now. I'm using something called Firefox Nightly. That is like the bleeding edge, the stuff that's coming up. And so we've got a number of interesting things coming up. And one of those things is something called tab groups. And that allows you to like take a series of tabs and basically put them in a bag that's labeled, you know, like news or my research on hamsters again. And I find that very helpful to kind of like segment the different things that I'm looking at. Despite all of that organization with tab groups and like searching through my tabs, I'll often find that I've like lots of duplicated tabs. And so there is a way to right click on a tab and close all of the other duplicates.
At what point did you realize like, okay, you know what? I have way too many tabs open. I can't find what I'm looking for. I need to find some type of skill, routine, plugin to manage this better.
I think it doesn't really kick in until I try and close the browser and it tells me like, are you sure you want to close the browser? Because you have like 300 tabs open. And I go, whoa, are you? Mm-hmm. I need to clean up.
Have you had any similar issues, Kim?
I mean, yeah, it'll pop up and it will say, are you sure? And I'm like, no, I'm not sure.
Wow. I'm talking to two people that have lots of tabs open at all times.
Yeah.
I get anxiety when I have that many tabs open. I'm someone that likes to keep maybe 4 tabs open. And then if it gets to maybe 8, I'm talking rookie numbers here compared to you guys, 8 tabs. And I start getting like, oh, you know what? I have too much going on. You know, like this is too much right now. And I know, you know, I should be better about kind of just being like, okay, you know what? That's there. That's there. This is why I have this open. This is why I have this open. But I still kind of lack that discipline to just...
Well, we're not saying it's great to have lots of tabs open, but it happens.
You guys are supposed to be teaching me what I'm supposed to be doing.
I can't teach you.
You teach us.
Well, because I've also found it, do you find yourself using the same number of tabs during a workday as you do kind of, let's say you're planning a trip to Hawaii or something like that. Do you find yourself in your personal life using the same number of tabs?
I don't think so. Like, I would say that I'm in the hundreds of tabs. I'll eventually I'll reach like some ceiling of like 200 or 300 tabs, and then I'll like declare tab bankruptcy and close them all. But of
Oh,
those tabs, I think there's probably only, I don't know, 20 or 21 individual domains. Bugzilla, you know, that's the bug tracking tool that we use for working on Firefox, or SearchFox, that's our like code search tool. It's usually tabs amongst those domains.
well, we know that Firefox was early in the game for a lot of different things that I wish were ubiquitous, like data protection, transparency. But I think Firefox was early on in the tab game too, right, Mike?
We certainly made tabs popular. Like, we brought tabs into the mainstream. It was one of the main selling points, from my recollection, anyways, of Firefox over our primary competitor at the time, which was Internet Explorer.
I wanted to ask, I'm someone that always likes a kind of a distraction on the side. You know, I'm always watching something on maybe an iPad or my phone. Is there a way to kind of have that on one screen so I'm not finding myself using multiple devices?
One of my favorite features in Firefox Desktop is picture-in-picture. That's something I actually worked on in 2019. I was part of the original team that worked on that feature. I'm very proud of it. You know, like it works quite well. I think personally, I'm biased, but I think it's like the best implementation of picture-in-picture across like all of our competitors. Firefox is unique in that you are able to open multiple picture-in-picture player windows. So if you happen to be watching like March Madness, if you're a basketball fan and you need to
Right.
watch like three basketball games at the same time, you can absolutely do that in Firefox, and I don't believe you can do that in any other browser. Yeah, I'm particularly proud of that feature. It also does captions, which I think is pretty neat. So if you're watching a video that has like subtitles or something, it'll show up inside of the player window.
So let's say you're in a Zoom meeting for, I don't know, something, a production for a show, I don't know, and you are bored. Could you just watch something with the captions on and
100%.
look like you're in the
100%.
meeting? Okay.
I have another one too. This is actually something we discovered during like the lockdowns when people were working from home and maybe they had like young children on their lap. They would sometimes open up like a children's show or something in picture-in-picture and then put the headphones on the child on their knee and then they would work on their, you know, do whatever their work was while the child watched the show nearby. Like that was something we heard people were using picture-in-picture for, which kind of surprised us, but it was an interesting discovery.
Do you have any favorite tab-related browser extensions?
Actually, no.
Okay, we'll skip that one.
I have
Couldn't
lots
ask
of keyboard
that
shortcuts
anymore.
I could share if that's helpful.
All
Yes,
right. I wanted the shortcuts. So,
So, Command W, that's going to close a
okay.
tab. Or if you're on Windows, Control W. Now, if you closed a tab by accident, Control Shift W, or on macOS Command Shift W, will reopen that closed tab. So, you know, if you need to revive a tab, bring it back from the dead, it's very, very easy. Switching between tabs, I'll do that with a keyboard as well. On macOS, that's yeah, Control Tab, and then Control Shift Tab to go in the other direction. It's the little things that over time will speed you up. Little keyboard shortcuts, little efficiencies that will add up over the course of an hour or a day and save you many minutes. And those minutes add up to hours.
Speaking of saving minutes that add up to hours, do you use any password managers?
Yes, I use 1Password. So that we like password managers are just a really good idea, flat out, like for anybody. You can memorize 1Password and that allows you to open up the vault of passwords. And I find 1Password is quite good at generating passwords for sites, and pre-filling the passwords that I need. Like if I'm ever typing a password into a site, something's gone horribly wrong. It's usually a bad sign. Maybe the site's trying to trick me. Maybe I'm not actually at the site that I think I'm at. So whenever 1Password, my password manager isn't trying to autofill the password, it's like, okay, immediately I'm on guard. And that's a good thing because, you know, every now and then people try and sneak one by you.
Mike, can you tell us more about multi-account containers?
Yes, I can. So this is a novel feature that I don't think exists in other browsers, but it's very nice. What it allows you to do is to have a tab open that belongs to a particular what we call a container. So for example, I have a personal container, and that personal container is one where I'll be logged into a bunch of like personal websites, my personal email account. And then I have like a work container that's the one where I'm logged into a bunch of like my work related sites, and they don't interact with one another. Like the sites are not aware that I am
Ooh.
logged in the other container. So for example, I can be logged into Gmail, my Gmail account in my personal container, but I can also be logged into Gmail, my different Gmail account in my work container, and it's not like they're connected in some way. They're like very distinct, and I have a banking container, and I do all of my banking in one particular container.
I actually did want to ask about some of the projects that you work on. Is there a certain way that you implement, and we may be getting way too detailed here, but could you tell us a little bit about how you A/B test this with people that use Firefox?
I remember a time in the not too distant past, but like within my tenure at Mozilla. I've been at Mozilla for about 13 years at this point. And maybe in the first couple of years I worked here, the way things were done, at least on the team I was on at the time, is you'd get some designs, you'd implement them, you'd ship them automatic, like by default to everybody, and then you'd kind of hope that people liked it. And then you'd read like the tech press, and you'd read Slashdot and Reddit, and you'd try and figure out like, did people like it or not? We don't know. It's not so much guesswork anymore, or it's not as much guesswork, because it used to all be guesswork. And so you'll come up with a potential solution, and then you can user test it. So you don't even have to necessarily implement it. You can take the design and put it in front of one or more people and like tell us what you think, basically, and drive it around. Maybe it's something like a paper prototype or like a kind of almost like a slide deck prototype where our designers have instrumented it a little bit, but it's not like a program or anything, but they can kind of click around. And from that, you can get a lot of really valuable information on whether or not the interface makes sense to people. Does the language make sense? Is it satisfying visually? And then once you have that information, then you can start maybe developing either a prototype or you actually build the thing. You build the thing. And once you've built it, you don't necessarily just like lob it into the public and turn it on by default for everyone. We have the ability now to like turn it on for a small percentage of the user
Right.
population and, ask them like, did you like that? What do you think of this? Sometimes we won't even put it necessarily in the browser for it. Maybe we'll like write an add-on and put the add-on on addons.mozilla.org. Like the multi-account containers thing that we were talking about before, that's an add-on. So you go to addons.mozilla.org and you install that, and that is what you then use to use containers, and you can give us feedback about that particular feature because of that add-on.
So you mentioned Firefox Nightly before, which is what I wanted to call this show, but we couldn't do it for some reason. What I want to know, is that something that anyone can access, or maybe just someone like you?
No, anyone can use it. If you just do a search for Firefox Nightly, it'll be the first result. And what it is it's the bleeding edge of Firefox development. So the stuff that we landed yesterday in the source code will be in today's Nightly. And the stuff that I landed in today's source code will be in tomorrow's Nightly. And so, you're getting updates every day. The person using Nightly is someone who isn't afraid of a browser that might behave a little strangely from time to time, that may suddenly feel strangely sluggish and then the next day it's fine. Or suddenly some of the colors have changed a little bit and then the next day they change back. Because we're landing things and then people are using Nightly and then they go, that button changed and it wasn't supposed to. Oh, then we better go fix it. And like that's how we catch it. And so it's helpful actually whenever people are using Nightly to report bugs, to report issues to us, because that's what it's for. It's for people to try it and report problems. It's also the trade, like that's very helpful for developing the browser, but the trade as the Nightly user, what you get is the latest and greatest. Like you're getting right now, I've got vertical tabs enabled by default. I've got tab groups enabled by default. I've got like some new experimental layouts that we're doing in new tab enabled by default. And this is available to me because I'm on Nightly.
Are there any other projects in the pipeline that the user could maybe start looking forward to?
Yeah, I'm really excited for vertical tabs. This is another thing for my fellow tab hoarder and I to sort of like nerd out about, but like horizontal tabs are how I've been using tabs my entire like browser life. I'd heard of people using things like side tabs, side Barry entry style tabs, and it never really clicked for me. But we've had a team working on like a built-in version of vertical tabs, and it's exactly what it sounds like. You take your horizontal tab strip and then you just stick it on the side of the browser instead, so it's like a vertical list. And then the tab strip along the side can collapse, so it becomes this like thin strip along the side, and I've got a keyboard shortcut to open it up so I can see all the tab titles and then close it again. I am very excited about vertical tabs and tab groups. Both of those things are pretty neat. And you know, I'm these days focusing a lot on working on the new tab page with a bunch of really smart, awesome people. And we've got some interesting things coming down the pike there. We're going to try some variations on how it's laid out and how it's organized. Right now, it's this grid of interesting stories, but we might want to try and break it up into like topics, you know, the sections that are about technology and a section that's about gardening or sports or space or something like that. And then people can like choose which topics maybe they're interested in and less interested in, and they can really kind of tune it to how they want it to be. Which
Right.
is kind of the MO of Firefox, really. It's supposed to be a thing that you can tune so that's how you want it to be.
Well, Mike, thank you so much for giving us all of this incredibly practical advice and stuff to look forward to in Firefox Nightly. I will be looking for those vertical tabs. So thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Let us know in the comments if you are a tab hoarder or a tab minimalist, and also let us know if there's any shortcuts you know of.
Subscribe to the channel and be sure to download Firefox because you know it's the best. We'll see you next time.